Hello everybody and welcome to Rate the K, where I rate and share my opinion on K-pop songs. My name is Plummy, or Paige, whichever you prefer to call me, and in this video I'm gonna be reacting to Chungha's Stay Tonight, GWSN's Bazooka, and NCT Dream's Ridin. So without further ado, let's just jump right into it, starting off with Stay Tonight by Chungha in 3, 2, 1. I'm hoping that this song is gonna sound different from Snapping and Gotta Go, because to me Snapping was just like a second half to Gotta Go. It was basically the same song with nothing really interesting or different done to it, and I ended up loving the song, but it felt too similar to Gotta Go. And already I can see that this one is very different from Snapping. Yeah, it definitely sounds very different. Oh, that outfit looks great on her. And that hair too. It's a bit weird seeing her with bangs like this. Because I'm kind of used to seeing her with like her hair parted normally. Ooh, those vocals! I'm not surprised how different this sounds from Gaga. It's like a completely different sound. I'm liking that fact that it's completely different, but I'm still not sold on the song. Cause like when I reacted to Gotta Go and Snapping, at least for Gotta Go, I instantly knew it was a 10 out of 10. Snapping, almost the same, it was just too similar to Gotta Go for me to really like it. But this one, I'm not instantly won over. She's definitely killing it with the vocals though. These are honestly some of my favorite high notes from her. Honestly, I'm really impressed. This is so different and it still feels so good. I'm just still not 100% into the song. Like, it doesn't demand me for me to listen to it constantly, but it doesn't really have to do that. It's just not that kind of song. Okay, so let's get into it one more time before I share my opinion about it. In 3, 2, 1. This music video is beautiful, by the way. It's very high quality. Honestly, I kind of like a huge part of the choreography. Not exactly sure how I feel about the chorus part, but Parts like this are really, really cool. I really like it. I think I definitely like this more than snapping. I just haven't really grown into it yet. Yeah, this is my favorite outfit of hers. You know what, I'm gonna get in what I was about to say after the reaction. I don't wanna waste time right now. She looks beautiful in that dress, like, and with that hair. She's like a goddess. And again, that high note. Okay, so what I wanted to say is that some of the dance moves from girl groups, I really don't like how sexualized they come off. I really don't like that. And some of the dance moves in this song are like that, and it annoys me. But I gotta say though, parts of the song which sound like this, I love it. This sounds so good, and there's certain emotional feeling that her singing gives off that I really like. I don't know, maybe it's melancholy, maybe it's just sadness. I like it so much. I would listen to this song only if only for that part. Like, the dance moves that are sexualized are not really that egregious in this song, but I don't know, I've just for some reason started noticing it more recently, especially in the last few days. Even though I haven't reacted to anything in the last few days, I just watched some music videos, and I don't know, I just don't like it. I don't like it. Anyway, getting into the song. So, I definitely think it's better than snapping, if for nothing else because it's so different, but even if we ignore the fact that it's so different, it just feels better, feels more sophisticated, feels deeper. Even though I haven't seen the lyrics and I don't know what the song specifically is about, it just gives off that kind of vibe, and I like that, I love that, especially as I said, those moments in which it sounds, I don't know what's the word, it gives a really cool feeling that I really like, and those moments really make me love the song. The music video, as I said, is high quality. No matter how you look at it, it's beautiful. Chungha's outfits are all beautiful. She looks beautiful. She performs great, and her high notes are out of this world. Honestly, I'd say I love this song. I'm still not sure whether I'm gonna be really listening to it, because it's not really the kind of song that demands my attention and demands me listening to it constantly, but I also think it's a really good song, honestly. So while it's not gonna be a 10 out of 10 personally, I'm definitely gonna give it at least a 9.8, which might as well be a 10 out of 10, but it's not. It just, if it was a song like, let's say, Everglow's Dun Dun, which when it came out, I constantly listened to it for about a week. If it demands it the same way, yes, I would be willing to give it a 10 out of 10, but right now, it's gonna be a 9.8. Although, objectively, I don't think anybody can say anything bad about this song, if I gotta be honest. So yeah, it's gonna be a 10 out of 10, objectively, for sure. So, let's get into the next song of this video, that being GWSN's Bazooka. And I'm not sure if I've ever reacted to GWSN, because I get them frequently confused with WGSN. I don't even know if they're the same group or whatever. I just get them frequently confused the two, so if I have reacted before to them before, check out the video, just look up on my channel. But yeah, so yeah, I guess let's get into it and see how this song is gonna sound like, because my preconceived notions for the song right now is that it's gonna be probably cute. I don't know, but even if it's cute, that doesn't mean it's gonna be bad. So let's get into it in 3, 2, 1. Ever have that feeling where you're not sure if you're awake or dreaming? Yeah. Yeah. For me it happens because frequently I switch whether I'm awake during the day or during the night. The set for this music video is kind of solo in the fact that it's obviously kind of a rundown building that they're using. And I gotta say, I like the fact that K-pop music videos are able to make those kind of rundown places look great. And who the hell is the girl with the short hair? Cause she piqued my attention, that's for sure. What the hell is that? Honestly, I'm so curious right now. Also, I don't want to be harsh, but the music video is definitely a bit on the lower quality side. It's nowhere near bad or anything. It's a respectable music video, but it's obviously more on the low budget side. And so is the song a little. But again, that doesn't mean it's gonna be bad. Yeah, I'm curious about that member. I'll have to look up this group. Probably in between between the second reaction to this song. I gotta say, the song sounds kind of interesting. It's obviously a cute song first and foremost, but it loses a lot of cool girl crush beats, I guess I could call them, I don't know. Like beats you would frequently hear in a harder hitting song, and I like that. And I'm so infatuated with that member. I don't know who she is, but she's already my bias. That's it. She's killing it with that haircut, I gotta say. Okay, so I definitely have to learn who that member is. So I'm gonna be back in a second once I do that. Okay, so let's learn a little bit more about the group. This is not what I usually do, by the way, so this is kind of a one-time thing. Okay, so GWSN is a 7-member girl group under Miles, a sub-label of Kiwi Media, I have no idea. Consisting of Seryeong, Sikyung, An, Minju, Soso, Mia, and Lena. Okay, so first we have Seryeong. She is my age. Korean. Okay, I'm mostly interested into that. Okay, I guess that's... Okay, so that's her. She's called Mia, apparently. Okay, so... Mia Uchiharuka. Okay. I would definitely like her. She's definitely my bias. I usually tend to bias the rappers in the group. Yep. Definitely. So she is 7 years older than me. She's Japanese. Okay, let's see some of the facts. Looks like I don't know who that would be. Cover group called Bax. Okay. Her role model is FX Amber. Well, clearly. Girl crush, yep, I see that. Only 4 months, that's very little. Her motto is just do it. Well, I guess we have something in common. Because the first half of my motto is just do it. The other half is Nantoka Naru, which is in Japanese, and it means it will work out somehow. So when you combine it, it's just do it. It will work out somehow. As long as you keep trying to do whatever you want to succeed at, you're gonna eventually succeed, whether it's sooner or later. And so far, that motto genuinely hasn't failed me. So yeah. Okay, let's see next. It's Seokyung. She's 1999. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna be just scrolling over these ones because I was curious most about Mia. She is Korean. She is my age and also a rapper. Minju. She is 1 year younger than me. She's Korean and she's a rapper too and a vocalist. Damn. So how is she 1 year? Are you kidding me? How the hell is she 1 year younger? She doesn't look like... Nah, she doesn't look 19. She's Taiwanese. Okay, and Lena. Korean maknae, 2002. Okay. I'm clearly voting for Mia. Of course. I mean, to be fair, I'm genuinely not surprised that most people choose Mia. Because she just stands out the most. Yeah. Okay, I guess let's go back to my reaction to the song. And let's get into it one more time before I share my opinion about it. In 3... 2, 1. I like her skirt. Okay, I weirdly like it. Well, not weirdly, I kind of like it. The song. I mean. Honestly, I gotta mention something personal. A little. In the last few years, I found myself really liking girls with short hair, which before was never the case for me. And if you're confused right now, I'm transgender and I consider myself female even though I have not transitioned already. So technically I am a female and I like female, if you're confused. And I just can't stop looking at Mia. I could watch her, look at her for hours honestly. I felt the same feeling whenever Chaeyoung from Twice was with short hair. I'm getting sidetracked here though. You know why this song is resonating with me? Like, I don't think it's genuinely like a 10 out of 10 song, but I am liking it so much for some reason. I'm so into it. And yeah, my bias is definitely Mia. I love I genuinely love her aura. I freaking love her. I love this. I love her. God damn it. I'm genuinely in love with her. Okay, last time I didn't see this ending part. There's a difference between knowing that path and walking the path. Huh. That's a cool line. Okay, so... Well, I did not see that coming, that's for sure. Again, similarly to, was it April? I think it was April's song. Give me a second, I'm gonna check. A few videos ago, I reacted to, no, it wasn't April, it was Oh My Girls, Nonstop. Similarly to Nonstop, I kind of expected this song to be the filler song of the reaction, which I probably wouldn't really like, but I'm just doing it so I can have three songs to react to, not just two. But for some reason, somehow, these two songs managed to really surprise me and make me really like them. For different reasons, mind you. But I did not expect to like this song, genuinely. I'm so sold onto this, and I'm definitely into this group from now onwards. And if there are B-sides, I'm definitely checking them out, because I love this song. I think huge part might be because of Mia and her looks and her attitude and everything, but not necessarily, because there are some parts of the songs that just give me a really cool vibe, and I don't know, I can't exactly explain it, but I like it. For some reason, this song really resonates with me, you know, in a kind of a weird way, but I like it. And actually, personally, I'm gonna give this song a 10 out of 10 because I'm super into it, even though I don't think it's a song that is a 10 out of 10 because, as I said, the music video is lower budgeted, obviously. Doesn't matter to me, but it would matter to other people. And the song similarly has some sounds and beats you usually... it just comes off definitely on the low budget side as well. But honestly, I freaking love it, and personally, it is getting a 10 out of 10. Objectively, I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10, because I think it's still a really enjoyable song for almost everybody, except somebody who really hates cute concepts, which I don't. It's just kind of on the opposite side of what I usually enjoy, but I'm still into this song. I just can't give it objective 10 out of 10, because it's not. But yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to more releases from GWSN, and I'm so sold on this. And I'll definitely put Mia as my lock screen on my phone. Okay, let's get into the next song of this video, that being NCT Dream's Ridin. And I'm really excited about this, because I mean, this is the main thing of this reaction that I'm looking forward to, because I'm a huge NCT fan and their style of music. And since last year, NCT has moved to the style of music I loved from NCT 127, because they went from NCT 127 was mostly doing like the experimental, weird, hard-hitting, rap-heavy songs. But I feel like, I mean, not necessarily because Kick It definitely went back in that direction, but with releases like Superhuman, I thought they were kind of moving away from that, but I guess that's not the case. But still, I feel like in the meantime, NCT Dream has been killing it with those kinds of songs, because in the meantime, we got... what was the song that... It's actually one of my first videos on the channel, so go and check it out. Back then, I just started the YouTube channel, so don't expect the quality that you see right now, even though even now it's not the highest quality. But... Oh, it was Boom, it was Boom, it was called Boom. Like, Boom is much... It's very similar to what NCT 127 used to do, and it's a bit different compared to the older NCT Dream songs, because We Go Up was more vocally based. Like, I feel like the selling point of We Go Up was the vocal part, not the rapping part. Before that, I think Go was the only other song that was similar to Boom in that regard, that it was more experimental and rap heavy and everything. And ever since, I feel like they've moved to that kind of style. So I'm curious how this is gonna sound and whether I'm gonna be really loving it. So without further ado, let's get into it in 3, 2, 1. Ten out of 10. I think NCT Dream is my favorite unit. I love that they actually made them a fixed unit now, and that Mark is coming back. That was literally my wish. I guess God heard my prayers, even though I'm an atheist. I love how colorful this music video is, by the way. Everybody's hair is a different color, I feel like. Not necessarily, but it looks like it. It's super colorful and I love it. Similarly with their clothes, I love all their outfits. NCT Dream are so good, I love them. One thing I don't understand about NCT now is, why the hell did their sale explode all of a sudden? Like, I'm pretty sure that this mini album is like 500,000 pre-orders or whatever. Like, this is crazy. They weren't selling this much. They were selling like 200 at 3 at most. I don't think it even was that high. And all of a sudden, NCT is selling like 17 or GOT7 numbers. Not that I'm complaining about it, I want them to be successful, but just I don't get where did that come from all of a sudden? The dancing soul is so powerful and energetic. Can you imagine that these are the 6 guys from Chewing Gum? Chewing Gum! Chewing Gum is actually... was released, I think, right after my birthday in 2016, and a little bit before I got into K-pop. They've grown up so fucking much, and so have I. They're like, at this point they are young adults. They're not teenagers, they're young adults. I'm happy that this song did not disappoint. Oh my god, I loved everything about this. Okay, we're just getting into it one more time. You can't stop me. Let's get into it again in 3, 2, 1. This is just so good. I love everything about this. The performance, the music video, the outfits, the singing and rapping, everything is so good. And their attitude and presence, I love it. I love the way they act with facial expression and everything. It's so good, it's so powerful. One thing that Mark leaving the group helped, in my opinion, it's allowed the rest of the members to shine with the rapping, because before that I wasn't really caring about the others rapping because I know they had rapped before even with him there, but I didn't really pay attention to it. But ever since Mark left, honestly, I freaking love the rapping. I gotta learn the names at this point. Oh my god, stop doing that. Okay, this might sound weird, but I thought I didn't like guys. I'm weirdly attracted to them. At least I think this is what it's supposed to feel like. I just think they look so cool. This is so good, I love it. This is miles better, honestly, even than Boom. And I'm much more into this than NCT 127's Kick It. Definitely. Honestly, this is a serious contender for number one song of 2020. We'll see how much I'm gonna listen to it in the following days, but if it's not number one, it's definitely number two. It's not lower than that. Oh my god, I love their performance, it's so good. Damn, I'm honestly out of breath with this one. Holy shit. I mean, do I even need to say it? They killed it. They killed it in every possible way. Genuinely, performance was crazy energetic. I love everything about it. The rapping is awesome. The singing is awesome. Their outfits are awesome. Their attitude in the music video and facial expressions is awesome. I love it. The instrumental is great. Everything about this is really, really good. I'm super in love with this. And yeah, personally and objectively, it's actually gonna be 20 out of 10 on both. They fucking killed it. I love this. Like, I don't know if there's anything else I can say about this, but I love this. Wow. Like, this was so good. I'm blown away. I expected to enjoy it, maybe around a 9, but wow, I'm genuinely blown away. I haven't been this blown away in a long time, I feel like. I don't know. I feel like the last this good of a song that was released was Everglow's Dun Dun, that I enjoyed so much on first listen. So yeah, this was a really good song, that's for sure. So yeah, if you guys have any K-pop songs you want me to react to, make sure to comment it down below, and I'm gonna add them to my list, though I don't promise when I'm gonna get to your specific request, because I do have a lot of songs, and there are a lot of comebacks recently, and I want to react to all the B-sides and everything of those comebacks, so it's gonna take a while until I get to your specific request, but I'm gonna do it, most likely. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe. Also, check out the link in the description to my Twitter if you want to follow me there, or to my Wattpad, where I post my stories. And additionally, you can check out all my other channels in which I post different types of content, like my gaming channel, my TV show reactions and reviews channel, and my Yu-Gi-Oh/anime channel. And I've thought of doing these things in separate channels before. Now I'm gonna do it definitely from now on. It's gonna be everything on different channels, because I feel like that's gonna allow the channels to grow faster. So if you're interested in any of those types of content, check out those other channels. And additionally, if you enjoy all the type of content on my channels, my stories, you can go over to Patreon or Subscribestar, which are all these things linked in the description. Where you can support me and keep the channels going, help support me so I can keep writing the stories you enjoy. And additionally, I just want to mention that all the money you decide to support me with are gonna go towards my transition fund, because if you're new to the channel or just haven't realized it yet, I'm actually transgender, but haven't been able to transition for two reasons. I live in a transphobic country and can't afford it. So if you could help me out with that by donating, that would be greatly appreciated. It would mean a lot to me. You're gonna get a shout out on my channel for doing that. But I also don't want to guilt trip you into helping me out, so if you don't want to do it, that's completely fine. You can still help me out by liking this video, subscribing, and especially sharing this video with somebody who you think might enjoy it. And I think that's pretty much it for this video, so hopefully I'm gonna see you in the next one. Bye! Come on and get your game.